What's up?
So we have five compartments. It's kidneys, blood, liver, bile, and intestine. In the blood we have red blood cells. As any cells in human body, red blood cells also have to undergo self-renewal. So if red blood cells become old, red blood cells go to the spleen, where splenic macrophages destroy red blood cells with release of inner content. So with destruction of red blood cells, hemoglobin is released into the blood. Hemoglobin is degraded to protoporphyrin, and protoporphyrin undergo oxidation with formation of bilirubin. In the bloodstream, albumins almost immediately bind to bilirubin, thereby creating bilirubin-albumin complex. Such complex of bilirubin with albumins we call free bilirubin or unconjugated bilirubin or indirect bilirubin. In form of albumin-bilirubin complex, bilirubin is delivered to the liver tissue, where hepatocytes take up bilirubin from the circulation. Hepatocytes, by glucuronidation, bind to free bilirubin, a glucuronic acid, and the complex of bilirubin with glucuronic acid we call conjugated bilirubin or direct bilirubin. Then hepatocytes excrete a minor portion of conjugated bilirubin into the blood. Through the bloodstream, bilirubin is delivered to the kidneys, and kidneys excrete conjugated bilirubin into the urine, and exactly conjugated bilirubin gives color to the urine. Most of conjugated bilirubin hepatocytes excrete into the bile. With bile, conjugated bilirubin is delivered to the duodenum, and then intestine excrete conjugated bilirubin with feces. The normal level of unconjugated bilirubin in the blood is between 2 and 12 micromoles per liter. Because the major portion of bilirubin that incomes to the liver is excreted into the bile, the level of conjugated bilirubin in the blood is lower. The normal level of conjugated bilirubin in the blood is between 0 and 5 micromoles per liter. So the level of total bilirubin in the blood is between 2 and 17 micromoles per liter. But sometimes bilirubin level can increase. This condition we call jaundice, and we have three patterns of jaundice. The first pattern is increased mostly in indirect bilirubin, this condition also classified as prehepatic jaundice. To explain patterns of jaundice, let's make a simplified scheme. So hemoglobin is contained inside the red blood cells. Once hemoglobin is released into the blood, it becomes free bilirubin. Then liver uptakes free bilirubin and converts by glucuronidation into conjugated bilirubin. Part of conjugated bilirubin is excreted by the kidneys into the urine, another part is secreted into the bile and then excreted by the intestine into the feces. So the first cause of prehepatic jaundice is hemolysis or hypersplenism that causes destruction of red blood cells. The higher the red blood cells destruction, the more free bilirubin will be formed. Part of free bilirubin is uptaken by the liver and converted into conjugated bilirubin. This causes increase in conjugated bilirubin in the urine, which gives urine a dark color. And also this causes increase in excretion of bilirubin into the feces, and this gives feces a dark color. So in hemolysis, the causative factor is massive increase in production of indirect bilirubin. And because of this, the concentration of indirect bilirubin is higher than the concentration of direct bilirubin. For example, total bilirubin is 41, indirect bilirubin is 34, and direct bilirubin is 7 micromoles. As we see, the level of total bilirubin is significantly higher than normal. And as we look at fractions of bilirubin, we see that this elevation is caused by increase in free bilirubin. Most probably, the cause is increase in free bilirubin formation, and the most common factor is destruction of red blood cells with hemolysis. The concept is that if some pathological factor causes damage to red blood cells, with increase in red blood cells destruction, the release of hemoglobin into the circulation increase. This causes increase in formation of protoporphyrin, and because in the bloodstream protoporphyrin is converted into free bilirubin, the concentration of free bilirubin dramatically increases. The problem is that liver has only limited capacity to uptake free bilirubin from the blood, and because of this, liver uptakes bilirubin at relatively slow pace. so only a small part of this extra free bilirubin can be uptaken by the liver tissue. Increasing uptake of free bilirubin results in increasing production of conjugated bilirubin. This results in increasing excretion of conjugated bilirubin into the urine, which gives urine a dark color, and also this causes increasing excretion of bilirubin into the bile and subsequently into the feces, and this gives feces a dark color. Also, increasing hemolysis of red blood cells can be caused by increasing splenic activity, so-called hypersplenism. The second cause of prehepatic jaundice is hereditary disorders of conjugation. The concept is that in hereditary disorders of conjugation, as in Gilbert syndrome or Crigler-Najjar syndrome, glucuronidation is not working properly. So liver is not capable to make from free bilirubin a conjugated bilirubin. As a result, the level of free bilirubin increased, and the level of conjugated bilirubin decreased. This results in decreasing concentration of conjugated bilirubin in the urine that causes urine discoloration, and in decreasing concentration of conjugated bilirubin in the feces that results in discoloration of the feces. So in this case, also the concentration of indirect bilirubin is higher than the concentration of direct bilirubin. So in hereditary disorders of conjugation, glucuronidation occurs at very low rate. As a result, the amount of free bilirubin increase and reach 20, for example, and the amount of conjugated bilirubin decrease and becomes 1, for example. With decrease in conjugated bilirubin, the excretion of bilirubin decrease. As a result, the concentration of bilirubin in the urine decrease, this causes urine discoloration, and the amount of bilirubin in the feces decrease, and this causes discoloration of the feces. The second pattern is increase in both direct bilirubin and indirect bilirubin. This condition also classified as hepatic jaundice. Hepatic jaundice occurs due to the liver injury. In this case, both free bilirubin and conjugated bilirubin will leak from the liver tissue into the blood, and this will cause increase in both free bilirubin and conjugated bilirubin. For example, total bilirubin is 75. As we see, the level of total bilirubin is significantly higher than normal. And as we look at fractions of bilirubin, we see that this elevation is caused by increase in both unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin. The most common cause is liver damage due to the drug-induced liver injury or hepatitis. With damage to hepatocytes, hepatocytes die, and their inner content is released into the blood. As we see, in this case, both free bilirubin and conjugated bilirubin enter into the bloodstream. As a result, the level of both free bilirubin and conjugated bilirubin increase. But also with liver damage, the uptake of free bilirubin becomes impaired, and this causes additional increase in the level of free bilirubin in the bloodstream. The higher the concentration of conjugated bilirubin in the bloodstream, the higher the excretion of bilirubin. So this causes increasing excretion of conjugated bilirubin into the urine, which gives urine a dark color. But with liver damage, the excretion of bilirubin into the bile becomes impaired, and as a result, the concentration of bilirubin in the feces will decrease, and this causes light color of the feces. The third pattern is increasing indirect bilirubin. This condition also classified as posthepatic jaundice. In posthepatic jaundice, the entire bilirubin pathway works fine, but the outflow of bilirubin from the liver tissue into the intestine becomes impaired. No bilirubin in the feces, no color. So the first sign is stool discoloration. As a result of the obstruction, conjugated bilirubin begin to accumulate, then conjugated bilirubin absorbed into the blood and subsequently excreted in the urine. And because in this case, there is massive increase in conjugated bilirubin in the blood, there will be massive increase in concentration of bilirubin in the urine, and this gives urine a very dark color. So in case of posthepatic jaundice, the concentration of direct bilirubin prevails over the indirect bilirubin. For example, total bilirubin is 50, indirect bilirubin is 17, and direct bilirubin is 33 micromoles. As we see, the level of total bilirubin is significantly higher than normal. And as we look at fractions of the bilirubin, we see that this elevation is caused by increase in conjugated bilirubin. Most common cause of prehepatic jaundice is obturation in the biliary tract. So, if obstruction of the common bile duct develops, the conjugation of the bilirubin works fine. So, all bilirubin that is produced in our bloodstream is uptaken by the hepatocytes. Hepatocytes conjugate bilirubin with glucuronic acid, and as a result, conjugated bilirubin produced. But the problem is that the majority of the bilirubin is excreted through the bile. And with obstruction of the bile duct, we cannot excrete conjugated bilirubin. So conjugated bilirubin initially accumulate in the biliary tract and then undergo absorption into the blood. As a result, the level of conjugated bilirubin in the blood dramatically increase. From the blood, conjugated bilirubin is excreted into the urine, and because of this, the concentration of bilirubin in the urine rises dramatically, and this gives urine a very dark color. Also, with obturation, bilirubin cannot pass into the intestine. Decreasing concentration of bilirubin in the stool results in stool discoloration.
Okay. Fine. Yep.
Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.